Rajiv is, has already joined. I would like to, Rajiv, you can start because let us not wait for this.
Yes, sir.
Let me introduce you now, and because two participants are already here, so why don't we start?
Yes, sir. If you say we can start as well and let others join as well.
Let me introduce you first to the other participants. So we have a guest presenter today. It is Rajiv Datta, Mr. Rajiv Datta. He has a long experience of working with different Wikimedia products, projects. I am particularly using the term Wikimedia here because it is Wikimedia Foundation that owns all the sister projects of Wikipedia. Wikipedia is a brand name, but there are several projects that are being run by Wikimedia Foundation. And the projects that I recall are Wiktionary or Wikidata or Wikivoyage or Wikibooks or Wikiuniversity and so many other projects are there. So Mr. Datta is going to give you an idea about different other projects also, and also about the work that he's done. And he will also let you understand and do help you do the work that you want to do on Wikipedia or other sister projects. So over to Mr. Datta.
Thank you, sir, for the introduction. I'd like to first introduce myself. My name is Rajiv Datta. I am from Kolkata. I'm a software developer working in Kolkata itself. As far as Wikimedia is concerned, I've joined Wikimedia projects. Not projects, actually, I joined as a Wikipedian to edit Wikipedia around 4 years back. Already crossed 4 years, first in December 2016. And after joining the Wikipedia movement, I found out that there are other sister projects where anyone can contribute from any part of the world. So the projects that I have worked that I'm going to explain to each and everyone so that you may have some thinking of working on to them, because there are several projects for different people to contribute as well. And as far as my journey is concerned, I'm very fortunate to meet different people from different parts of the world. I've been into different conferences as well, international and national, regional based as well. Wikimedia is a project that is, all the sister projects are run by a nonprofit organization called Wikimedia Foundation, based in San Francisco, United States. And we as a volunteer, we doesn't get anything while editing or contributing to Wikipedia, but definitely we are sometimes get boosted up by getting some gifts from the foundation. We get the chance to be a part of conferences for free, where you're traveling, your lodging and your fooding even taken care of by the organizing organizations. Mostly it's the Wikimedia Foundation itself. And again, one more gaining that I gain is I got the chance to meet different people from different culture, language, nationality as well. So it's a nice place to work on. And now I feel there's not a single day that I doesn't edit. Edit means doing something on any of the Wiki projects each and every day. Nowadays, I work as a mostly in Wikimedia for as a organizer, as a mentor for differential projects, which I'm going to show you up as. So, sir, can I share my screen as well?
Please carry on. The stage is yours, Mr. Datta.
Thank you, sir. Can anyone see my screen? Just confirm.
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay, sir, thank you. I'd like to show you first my profile a bit, just to go through my profile once again. Everyone can have their profile. This is my profile with my username as Marjowski. That's my username. Anyone can create a username. I will go and let you know what exactly how one can go ahead and create a username and an account. And these are the different. This is the actually Wikimedia Commons is this one is the repository of photographs or any media content from all over the world. And if anyone go to the main page, one can check out the first page that comes up when Commons comes up. It's called the Wikimedia Commons. So it's a part of the Wikimedia Foundation projects. And if you go down this page, you come to know what exactly the different other projects that Wikimedia Foundation has. The brands are, these are the brand names. Wikimedia is, Wikipedia actually is the most famous and the outstanding project of Wikimedia Foundation, where we go through about working on different articles in different languages. We have at this moment more than 300 languages articles in Wikipedia. And even when I joined Wikipedia, I didn't know that even there are regional language-based articles as well. I will just show you once again what exactly Wikipedia is. Basically, it goes directly to the English Wikipedia version. Because normally, even in Google, if you search for any informations, it shows you the link of English-based articles or information. But if you scroll down the page, you can see there are different name of the different languages found on. For example, Bangla, that is my mother tongue, Bangla. I'm a Bengali. Then we, and if you just take the mouse, you will see the different name comes up. That's the Bulgarian, then the Bosnian, Catalia, and these are all the different languages present for different articles. And if you just scroll down, you'll see more articles about it. And the first thing that I like to tell you is about the simple English. Simple English is a particular project in Wikipedia where the articles are written in very simple languages, simple English text for easy understanding. So this is the complete list of, and if one wants to search for any article, you can here put as, for example, if I'm searching my city, I put it as Kolkata, and Kolkata will show up with the different languages the article is present on. And anyone with their username can edit or add any informations to this article after reading this article as well. I will show you how to do that as well. This is the page of Kolkata, and these are different languages on which Kolkata article is written. So one can scroll down again. Bangla is there. And there are a lot of Indian languages will be there. Bhojpuri is there. Fiji Hindi is there, different types of Hindi is there, and you could say Hindi as well. Konkani is there, Hindi is there. Maithali is also there. It's also a language of Nepal as well. Marathi is there. Nepali is there. We have Santali, this is the Santali language. So these are the number of languages that is can, that Kolkata article is based on. One can easily go to the different sections of the articles by going through this info box. It's called the info box, where the different paragraph have been segmented with different sections. So one can go through and can check and can add as well. Now this is we call Wikipedia is all about. Now if I go back to the main page, there are the other projects. For example, Wiki Voyage is a project, as it says, free travel guide, which I often use and which I also often contribute as a Wikimedian. Now, as I said, again, all the projects will start with the initial English language. That is the reason it shows EN at the top. That means English. So this is welcome to Wiki Voyage, the free worldwide travel guide that you can edit. So it's a travel guide, you can say. So again, if I go ahead and check for my city.
Sorry to disturb, Mr. Rajiv.
Yes,
is it
yes,
possible for you to enable the chat so that if at all we are want to ask any questions or any queries, so we can post over there?
I think the chat is on. You can easily post. Dr. Arunji, the chat is on. You can use the chat as well.
Yeah, just on.
And okay, definitely thanks. I will have some small breaks for 5 minutes so that we can drink something, or in the meantime, after that, we can have a small question round as well. And in between, if you have any question, please put it on the chat and definitely I will answer one by one.
Is the chat not on?
Yeah, it's on for me. I just putting it at hello on the chat. I think anyone
yes,
can see
it. Yes, it is on, sir. Actually, I tried just 2 minutes back, so it wasn't.
So okay, right. So please ask questions. And please give your feedback or whatever you want. We can do that also.
Mm-hmm. And I like to tell everyone that anytime you want to interrupt me, you can do that. And if you feel that I'm going a little speed up, I can also slow down as well. So as everyone wish, and I can go ahead in that way. So will I go ahead, sir?
Yeah, carry on, please.
Okay. So this is the WikiVoice that I was talking about. It's not an article actually. It gives you information about the places you want to visit. So it's for a tourist, it's a very good guide, you can say. So if you go to Kolkata, you can see the different sections like history, then a bit of economy. And the most important thing that I like about this WikiVoyage project is you can get information about climate, and then the way, the different transport by which you can reach the city, by plane, by train. Even the local trains also are given, railway stations, buses. So these all the information have been uploaded by travelers who have visited the city, or there are Wikipedians from the city itself. I've been one of them, and there's another Wikipedian I know. His name is Rangon Dotto. He's also very active in this particular WikiVoyage project. You can see all the information in regards, and anyone can visit this particular page and can add as well whenever they're visiting. You can see the spiritual places to visit also mentioned. What you need to do, there are different ways to go through the city, river ride, you can, what are the work places to visit as well for volunteering, what to buy, how to eat, everything is mentioned on this. And though I will not guarantee that all informations about all the places in the world are available on WikiVoyage, but you might get at least some informations in English because there are other languages as well. So if you go up the page, you can see what are the languages available for this particular informations. It's very less. I think it's 6. It's Bangla is there. Deutsch is there. There's German. Then Persian is there. So if you go to any of them, you might get less information compared to the English information here. So again, we often speak to different conferences or workshops that we have so that people can come and translate these informations into their languages and can add as well. It not need that you need to know everything. You can come to this page and translate the informations here in this in own language. Because for example, we can't see Hindi is there. So anyone who's a Hindi speaker and who wants to edit in Hindi can open up, create a new page for Kolkata, and they can just simply translate the information into their language as well. So this is all about WikiVoyage, where you
Mr.
get...
Dutta, should I interrupt, Mr. Dutta?
Yes, please.
Actually, there's a question from Rasmiri that is... do all the pages provide their own set of information? So I would like to know the pages, I mean, sister concern. Okay, so her question is, the pages on different projects, do mm-hmm. they have common information or separate information? I think I have asked the right question. Rasmiji will correct me if I'm wrong.
Okay.
Thanks, sir.
All right.
So... Rashmiji, can you just go ahead with the question once again?
So it's as it's right as Dr. Arun sir has rephrased that all these pages, no, Wiki Voyage or Wikimedia, Wikipedia, like you have shared this page. So do they carry the common information? Like if I go for Wikipedia, I'll get the same information or the different information? Like they'll have separate information for each sister concern or the common one?
Information, I'd like to tell you that if you're going to, for example, in Wikipedia and checking about Kolkata, for example, the article written about Kolkata or any place in Wikipedia will have less information compared to a page of a place in Wikivoyage, because Wikivoyage is giving you a full guide of the particular place about how you want to go ahead as a tourist. So Wikivoyage is different from Wikipedia in the sense that as a tourist point of view, Wikivoyage is the right place to check. And as a general information you're looking for, Wikipedia is the right place to check. So the information is going to be much less sometimes and much can be more as well. Depends upon the different topic.
I think it may have taken some information from Wikipedia also. It may not have. Depends.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Because it's some portion, yes, there are some informations taken from Wikipedia about the location of the place or what is the, if Kolkata is the capital of any state, this information are from Wikipedia. Else by how you roaming around the city by an auto or a taxi is all the information that's only present in Wikivoyage. So as a tourist point of view, Wikivoyage is the place where you need to check. And as a general person who are looking for informations, Wikipedia is the right place to check. Hopefully I've answered your question.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rashmi. Thank
you. Continue now then.
Yes, sir. Yes, I just continue. So this Wikivoyage that I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Just a moment. I'm having a trouble from one page. Yes, I got it. So now we can go to the next, which is most interesting, is about which is less active nowadays, is the third one, is that is Wiktionary. I will have a look on what exactly the Wiktionary is. Just like the Wiki dictionary, the dictionary that we have as a book. So Wiktionary is just you can say it's a digital version of a dictionary. Wiktionary is the free dictionary, which I am not active. I doesn't contribute to Wiktionary, but anyone can contribute to here and check about the different words that have been used. You can add the words by taking any reference, and it can be in any languages as well. So you can see the languages are already present in Wiktionary, and it's 150 or languages to be precise, where we have Bangla, we have Marathi, we have Hindi. So one can go to each of the sections and then check. Though I like to tell to all the participants here with my great regards, is that it's not easy to compile everything in one day, but definitely if you're interested, definitely I like to have more some sessions and can concentrate on a particular session on each day. I'm just trying to give a glimpse of what exactly the Wiki projects we were having. So that was Wiktionary. The next is Wiki News. It's a very interesting project, but you need to be very active on this. That means I'm talking about the timings to be a contributor on this. Wiki News is just a portal for information regards to what's happening around the world with updates. That means it's just like a news channel. So where people post as a reporter from different sources, and again. This is much less in terms of language diversion. So you can see only 24 languages are there for Wiki News. There is a very less in terms of India presence. That means I'm talking about Hindi or Bengali. There is no such project yet started. Though I once thought to start Wikinews regional project based on language. It can be Hindi or Bengali, but due to lack of volunteers, I didn't able to start. So, but there it is there in my mind to start one day. But you have to be very active. You have to stay sometimes at night, long at night, to write the news, because you need to update the pages every minute so that you get all the current news we posted on this particular page, that is the Wikinews. Now I'm moving forward for the next one. I think this Wiki.
One more question, but who checks for the authenticity of what you edit also, and the information that you include?
Regards to any project you're talking about, or
Or even the news out here,
Yes, I'll tell you. Basically, on every project that we have, on every Wiki media projects, we have a set of volunteers who have a particular positions for their experience. So, which we call often called as administrator or role pusher, which they often check, and they mostly check about the authenticity of news or any information that's updated on any of the Wikimedia projects.
Yeah.
And whenever they found any kind of vandalism or any kind of information which is not incorrect or misinformation, they remove it at the same time. So they are very active from different part of the world, and they do their work whenever they feel something is wrong on any of the post that is there on any of the Wikimedia projects. It can be Wikipedia, it can be Wikinews, or any sister projects.
Okay, Mr. Datta, so what more now?
Yes. Next is, as I said about Wikicode, then we, I'm going to for Wikicode, I think I haven't said about.
Because I would, if you finish, then I can give a demo to them on Wikipedia editing, how to do editing on Wikipedia or add contents to Wikipedia.
Yeah, definitely. So I just need another 10 minutes just to give an idea of what exactly the others are. So Wikicode is again is about sourced quotations from different authors or famous persons. So it's a page where you can get different quotes or quotes by different well-known people. You can see this is one is there at the top as from Ronald Reagan, the U.S. President, former president. So it's a page where you can write and add quotations of different people from around the world. But has to be published anywhere. The source has to be there, because the thing that Wikimedia projects always follow is that you need to source your documentation. Whatever you are writing on Wikipedia or any other projects, there has to be a formal reference, either a published one on internet, or it can be on a book. So that should be documented. The next we have is Wikiversity. It's a free learning resource, though actually all the projects are learning resource, but Wikiversity was created just to have a specific reason for, you can say it's a type of university where we have different projects related to scholarly. And so it's art, humanities, mathematics, medicines, science. So there are different topics that to speak on and to add. So again, informations are shared or sometimes you taken from Wikipedia. So these are informations mostly done by scholars. Anyone can go ahead and do that, but I'm not a part of this project. I don't edit on Wikiversity. Next, I will be running off for Wikisource. It's a very beautiful project where we scan different books for an online repository. So which are rare or not found, or so there are different projects going on across India as well, where people are scanning different books, even manuscripts as well, and putting it on internet for the digital viewers. So Wikisource is a project where you have the digital format of books. This is Wikisource. It can be found in different languages as well. Next is Wikibooks, which is actually founded for children for to creating books, like the e-books that we have. You can say about the Kindle, the Amazon Kindle is that. So Google, Amazon, all they take the information from Wikipedia or the different wiki projects for their work as well. So Wikibooks is a part of that. So Wikibooks is actually a digital format of books where people can create new books on the different topics like computer, engineering, humanities, languages, all the different topics we have. Next, the most interesting, which I often do, is Wikimedia Commons. As I said, it's a repository of for media content. It can be videos, still photography, audio files, video files. And today I'm going to show you a bit of Wikimedia Commons, how to work on Wikimedia Commons, because nowadays everyone have a smartphone, so they can easily come up and contribute to this project. And I'll show you how to upload photographs. The different contest happens on Wikimedia Commons. So I will share the information as well. So one can also take part. This is the Wikimedia and where you can search on this bar, any photograph you feel like, and it comes up automatically, or if anything has done, anybody has updated. I often post different photographs and I will show you some of them as well today, later on. Then is come Wikidata. It's again a fantastic project to speak on, where I also very active on this and have the most number of edits. I think it's more than 12,000 edits I have in Wikidata. Wikidata actually is a place where they connect all these sister projects in one place with different word that we use as items. So we can have a different sessions for Wikidata, how to edit on Wikidata as well. So anyone can edit again on Wikidata, and it's a very simple project to start editing. And I'll show you later on how exactly what is Wikidata is about. The research. On check this particular project of Wiki Species. Anyone can search on any of the projects on just typing on Google with the name, and you can reach to their homepage as well. So this is the free species directory that anyone can edit. It's more about the different insects, the animals that we have, the living thing. So this is all about the projects that we have in Wikipedia. And sir, the floor is yours. Before I dive, is there anyone have any questions still that? Anyone having any questions?
Sir, I think Deepika ma'am has asked one question in chat box.
I just checked.
Would you like to answer it?
Yeah. When I tried to add educational institutions in the Amritsar page, it's asking for citation. So kindly throw some light on how to add.
Okay, so I'll come back to this.
Yes. I think Dr. Arunji will help you out in that.
Okay. So.
Okay, Arunji, please go ahead.
So
thank you.
Then, Mr. Datta, should I share the screen now?
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
I'll do that. Yes. Okay, so thank you, Mr. Datta. I think you have already spoken about the different sister projects of Wikimedia Foundation. The group name we have given as Wikipedia Editing, but actually everybody, the common people, we all know this as Wikipedia. Wikipedia is the brand name. Everybody knows it like by that. But we should be aware that Wikipedia is the brand name. Actually, it is being used by people more often. If you talk about just English Wikipedia, there are 62 lakh articles on that. And then other projects, there are so many articles. But that is just one project. As Mr. Datta has already shown, there are so many other projects like Wiktionary and Wikidata and Wikimedia Commons and all those things. So I would, Dr. Kohli has asked a question. I will come back to that quickly. In fact, I would like to give a demo of the editing here on Wikipedia, because generally we are attracted towards Wikipedia and we refer to Wikipedia more often, the common we generally. So users. So I'll quickly come to, the main page. Yes. So this is the main page of Wikipedia. And this is the main page when I say this is the main page today. So I think I'll just take a quick tour of the page. I'll take you to this. What is there on the main page? You have on the main page, you have one article, this article you have, and which is called the featured article. That means the best article. And there are 9 types of categories: featured, then featured list, then good article, then A, B, C, then a stub and all those. So every day on the main page, there is one featured article. So the article of the best quality. We'll just quicker. And then you have on this side, you have news. Then did you know, these are the amazing facts. Then you have what is the importance of the day, and then picture, then these are the projects, these are the other areas of Wikipedia, and these are the projects about which Mr. Datta was talking. And then this is the list of the languages in which Wikipedia is available. But we'll come to the article, in fact, article section, because Wikipedia is famous for that. And you can see this is just an extract of the article. The full article is here. The full article is here. I have taken the, just quickly I'll show you how the article looks and why is it called the best article. Featured article is the best article in terms of quality. So it will have a lot of media files like photos, videos it may have. And then it will be supported by references. What Dr. Kohli was asking, citations they are called, citations. So can you count the number of citations which are there in this? There are 41 citations. This is the 41 number. So, and the article is not that long, but every other sentence is supported. You know, you 3, then 3-2, then you have all these things. So it is not that we can make a statement that Dr. Kohli was saying that she wanted to add the list of schools or colleges, but she has to support it with a reference. Maybe a reference would be the source. The source can be a newspaper, source can be a book. So if she wants to add even that Amritsar has this school, so about that, actually, she should take it from the newspaper about this school. Some news is there in the school, and then she can add. That is what actually I want to add here, in fact. And I'll quickly go to that. We don't have much time. I'll just quickly show you the links on an article, on Wikipedia article. What are the links? This link is called article. This is called talk. Talk is, I'll come to editing also. Quickly I'll come, but I'll just show you. On talk page, you have, first of all, about the article's quality and article's importance. As you can see in this box, the quality-wise, the article is rated as FA class. That means featured article. I have already told you. Importance-wise, this is of low importance. You can just check. This article has been included in Wiki Project Biography, Peerage and Baronage, and it is rated as featured article. And it is of low importance. And I have already given you a list of categories in which the articles are judged on the basis of quality. So now, as far as the talk page is concerned, you have the topics on which different editors have discussed. So these are parts of the process of making the article, and all the discussions, various kinds of discussions will be there on the talk page. Then you have edit. On edit, page, this is a page of edit. You will see the edit page looks like this. The actual article is like that, but when you are editing, you have to add such symbols and all which are available, which are required for editing. And then you can add topic, and then you can, sorry, article will go. We'll go to article, then again, a minute. Then you can see view history. This is the page where you will have the history of the editing which has been done on this article. So you can look at this from the left side. The last edit was done on 6th February. That means today at 21:12:06. And then the person whose name is here, Ambrogio was here. This is the name of the person. This must be an anonymous name. Normally people on Wikipedia, they change their names. Like even Rajiv Datta had changed the name, and he was he calls himself Marajoski, as if he's from Brazil or something. Anyway, so actually generally people do, because they don't want to give their identity, because at times there may be a difference of opinion. Not at times, very many times. There are sometimes when you have edit wars between two or three editors and all that. And the things that, so there is no point giving personal identity. So you can see the entire editing history is here, available here. Now we'll go to edit, article again. Now I will take you to the editing process. So for that I will choose an article on, you see, I have, because Jim Corbett, I think everybody knows, he was a naturalist, a hunter, and all that. So Jim Corbett's article, I have taken you to, and now I will take you to another article that is called, what is, this is another article on Wikipedia, which is called Mokama Ghat. So I'm sure you all know about Jim Corbett. You may not know about Mokama Ghat, but you might see that Jim Corbett had worked in Mokama Ghat. You can check in the history. You can check. Naturalist and writer Jim Corbett worked at Mokama Ghat railway station in the early part of this. When he was 18, he joined the railways at Mokama Ghat, and he established a school for the children of the staff of the railways at Mokama Ghat with the help of an educationist named Mr. Ramsharan. So this is, of course, this all this has been added by me. I had created the article, but in order to show you how to edit an article, I thought I'll take this only. I will come to Jim Corbett. In the article of, this is not mentioned. Check. Here is Western Railway, initially working as a fuel here. Actually, Mokama, this paragraph, as you can see, I will add here. I'll simply write, Jim Corbett this is a statement I want to add. Now, the citation. Where do I get the citation? I am taking a shortcut because I could have added completely a new piece of information, but I am not doing. I thought I should take a shortcut. I wanted to give a demo of the editing. So for that, I thought I should choose something easier. So this citation I'll take from here only. I'll go to edit here. And where is that? Here. So I will copy this citation. I'm taking a shortcut actually, because this is not a new piece of information, but I am confident even the article of Jim Corbett should have this. And so I want to add here. So this is the citation. I think Dr. Kohli will understand this. I have added the content and I am supporting the content from a source. Actually, this source, if you can look at, it is his own book. I am just giving it. It is his own book. And the book of Jim Corbett, title of which is My India. I generally give a space after that is equal to or something. So now let's see how to do, what is the next step? Next step is I will add summary. I will add the reason. Summary is the reason which I'll give. What is the reason for my editing? Adding content with a reliable reference. You know what the reference is? The reference is Jim Corbett's own book, where he writes that he had started a book, and that is what the reference is. Then the title of the book is My India. Let us see the preview. And in the preview, how it appears? Yes, started a school for the railway staff at Mukhamaghat. So if you want to rephrase the sentence, you can come back. You are welcome to speak. Anyone can speak here. I welcome you. You want to add something about him with any reference, you can do that. Now the reference, just check the reference that I have added. Where is the reference which appears? Where is that?
At serial number 5, sir.
Serial number 5, yeah. So you can check right now at serial number 5, it has already appeared. And this is just the preview. Now I will click the publish button. Should I click the publish button? I am confident now, so I can do that. I will do. So you can check in Jim Corbett's article, right in your presence, I have added the content. This is the statement I made. Jim Corbett started a school for the railway staff at Mukhamaghat. And this is number five reference. Now I will, remove this. I will come to the article page and I have not. So I, you can see that I have done some responsible editing. I have not done anything which is irresponsible or any opinionated. I have not made any opinion of my own. This is not my opinion. So when you want to do edit, you want to do editing on Wikipedia, I would always expect you to do things with responsibility and be neutral. Neutral means then you may be in favor of something, you may have an opinion in favor or against something, but while adding knowledge, we should be honest and committed. And there may be things which we know, but the Wikipedia will not accept. Editors might delete them if they are not supported with references, with citations. I'll give you an example of, I think I will finish it with, because already we are now close to 1 hour. I'll finish it with one story which I had read recently. You all must be knowing that Wikipedia's creation, it was started in the year, it was in 2001. Yes, it has completed 20 years. So there are many stories available about that. So recently, I think in 2017 or something, a lady got the Nobel Prize in some area of science. And suddenly somebody created an article on the lady. But you would be surprised to know that the article, when it was created on that lady, it was immediately deleted. It was put for deletion. And the reason who are active on Wikipedia, and if ladies are less active, women are less active, the articles about women are also very less, very, very less. So they have made a call to the ladies and the women to come and join the movement and to add contents, to write more and more about even women. But if they are giving a call, that doesn't mean that we should write anything and everything. We should write things with confidence, we should write with boldness, but at the same time, we should write with responsibility. We should write and support with reliable references. I think that is what I would. So I've just given you a demo of this. If you have any questions, you can ask. I'll stop. Should I stop share now? I think I'll stop share.
Sorry, but Professor, could you once again just show how do you see how the quality of the article?
Why I am encouraging people to do editing on Wikipedia, I want them to be empowered, because we are all users. Once you become contributor, then right. You become a better user. Point 04 are featured lists. Then you have 0.03 as A class, point, and then 0.5 you have good articles, and then 2% are B class, then 4.32 C class, and start, you can check and stub, and then lists and all that. Unassessed articles are actually not articles. Basically, they are not accepted. Once they are accepted, they always give the grading. So this is the list of the grades. So once you start doing editing, you know, you should check the quality of the article also. All the articles are not of the same quality. Some of them might be trash also. The editors have not taken note of that. So earlier I was not, doubtful about the contents. Now, when I go to Wikipedia, I am able to check also which article is better, which article is not good. Then the other scale is of importance.
Sorry to interrupt. What does start class and stub class mean?
The first few. Stub class is the first. I mean, list, I don't know. Stub one, when you create an article and you don't have, I'll show you some stub class articles also. I'll show you.
Okay.
1 minute. Right. And I will also show you. My own articles I am showing you. When I say my own articles, I mean, okay. No. The articles which I have created, sir, of course, people have added to that.
Just to interrupt you, Dr. Runji, you can go to the Wikipedia page and you can search there as well. You'll get the article name.
I know. I have already opened whatever I was. Thank you.
You're most welcome, sir.
This is the latest article that I created. I created a few months back. So I am not very prolific in writing on Wikipedia, because I'm very passionate about a topic, then I write. So, but I do a lot of research. Research is my forte. So now let's go to talk. I think after I created, they have not, nobody has added anything. You see, this is of start class. Ma'am, you can check this. Start, you have understood? So this is of start class. Now, how does it look? So how they have rated, we can go the technical things, but you can just check. There is no photo on this. And it's a very, very short article. The contents are not very many, only 2-3 paragraphs, 4 paragraphs. Each paragraph having 2-3 sentences. But the strength of this article, I am very confident and proud of this, is that even if there are how many sentences, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 9, then 11, 12. 12, there are about 12 sentences, lines, and references you check, there are 9. So almost for every line, or if not for every line, at least one, and you see the ratio of reference that I have given. So nobody can challenge it then. I am so confident about it. So this is what I can add: more photograph, people can add, other, you can add to this, maybe you can add to other articles, and this can be improved. So improvement can be done. Now I'll show you an article which I created in 2000. I thought I have to give something to the college where I had studied. So I created this article. These photographs I have not added. Like somebody like Mr. Datta must have added this, because he is an expert of media and he is a photographer also. So photos, but most of the contents are mine. And there's so many interesting facts. So I'll show you on the discussion page the rating. The rating here is, I'm happy to tell you that just as I submitted, it started with C class only. It did not, I mean, they did not give stub or start. They straight away gave me C class at that time. That was in 2012. So, and C class articles are 4%, if I recall. So I am proud of this article, and other people have added more contents like media files, photos and all. So when you look at the articles, you would be able to understand whether it is of which quality. One is by references, how references have been given. The other is what is the length of the article. Then the third is what are the photos and videos with which it has been, which have been included. So all these would make them as, either stub. Stub is the starting one, then the start or C. Or so mine is C. One article is C, then you can see start also. Then good articles, I have not got the rating, because alone you can't do. It's a collaborative project, and people, when they add more and more, you can do that, but it is challenging. So
where do you go again for seeing the ratings of the article?
Here, ma'am, like for each article
on Talk,
you have, see, Jim Corbett, you go to the Talk page. This is the article page. We are on the article page. To the Talk page. Talk page is the place where you get the rating, and you also get the discussions which take place on various topics in the process of making the article. There are various editors. They will challenge you. Just as you have asked me, why should we give rating as this? So then there'll be discussions. Somebody might ask, this citation or this reference is not very reliable. Supposing there is a reference from the Times of India, or there is a reference from Republic TV, and there is a reference from BBC. So which one would be more reliable?
Right.
You can understand.
BBC.
So I don't have to explain it to you. If there is a reference from Times of India and then a reference from the Hindu, naturally, I'll be more confident of Hindu. This is my personal choice. I don't have anything against the Times of India. Similarly, Republic is a non-source. So whether you want to rely on that or not, the choice is yours. But I don't know, Wikipedia editors also may not rely on them. So these are, when I'm saying reliable, at the same time, supposing there is a content which is available on Republic also and CNN also or NDTV also, then you should be happy. Then no one can challenge. Then there are two extremes having the same content. Then you're confident. Nobody can challenge. So this is how you create. For example, the name of our prime minister is ABC, supposing. Every news channel will say, every newspaper will say. So, of course, you don't need to write also that thousands and thousands of people will write. But there can be other contents today where there can be challenges, where there can be, controversies and like that.
Sure.
Any other question?
Sir, any guide to write references in the Wikipedia? Or to write a reference?
Did I come back? I think I have stopped the... for any problem about the editing of Wikipedia, the source is Wikipedia itself. I would give you a shortcut. I will give you a shortcut. Should I give you a shortcut? I think when I was doing the... I'll just share only again the screen. When I was doing the editing of Jim Corbett, you must have seen, what did I do?
Yeah, you simply copy down from that page. So
exactly.
Shortcut.
So, a shortcut. I took a shortcut. And as I did the right thing, nobody can challenge me. I did not do any vandalism. Did I do any vandalism? The copying was okay, I think there was no problem, because in one article, Mukama Ghat, there was something about Jim Corbett, which was valid for Mukama Ghat. In Jim Corbett also, it should be there because he had started a school, so it should be included in his biography also. And what I did, but I did it for the same content, but you know, there may be an issue where you want to use another content and then you want to use, I'll just check, I'll tell you. And then you want to add another source, and that source is not there in any other article. That may be a doubt. Yes, you're right. So what you can do is now, say, there is a reference here. This part, you can check. And up to, it is up to this. You have seen this. The reference is from which point to which point. Have you checked?
Yes, sir.
Actually, William Corbett and his wife, Mary Jan, who had previously married Dr. Charles James or whatever, who died at Etowah in 1857. This has been supported with a reference which comes somewhere in a, probably some book or something like that. So if you want to use this kind of reference, a book, then you copy and you remove these contents and you add your own. Like one more thing I'll add you. I think this is not as good. I will give you this one. This might help you better.
Which so basically, every sentence has to be supported with a reference link, is it?
If you, this will be the ideal thing, ma'am. What you have said, if you are able to support every sentence with a reference, then it will be ideal, but it may not be possible. You may write, a content may include 3-4 sentences, 5 sentences, and then a reference. It may also happen. Now, I think I have included, you see, Jim Corbett started. Yes, here, from here it should be actually. Sorry. I took you to the. See, from here, I had added this sentence. Jim Corbett started a school for the railway staff at Mukama Ghat. So you can check all the the format of this. This is called template. I am asking you to take a shortcut. And this is the shortcut, but you can get a template also on Wikipedia. You just type here citation templates or reference templates, and they will give you the template. Now I can create this template. How I will, what I'll do is I'll copy this, then site web would be fine. Supposing I am taking it from the web, URL is fine. After you are equal to, I will remove this HTTPS from here to here, you know, Mukama, what is that called? Mukama Ghat, up to Mukama Ghat, I will just delete. Copy the URL from where I'm taking the source and I'll paste it here. Then title, whatever is the title of the book or article, I will write here. I will remove this, I will delete it. Name of the author, again, Jim, I will remove. Last one, Corbett, I'll remove. And in place of this, I will fill in with the whatever is available, whatever you are trying to fill, year and all that. Page number, if you have, then you can add. Access date will be your own. Like today is 6th February. So if we are doing it today, then we'll write 6th February. So I'm showing you the shortcut way. You can check which template is suitable for you. You can copy also from here. You can go to search. I'll now come to the article. You can go to search and you can also search the templates. I don't know. I think right now I'll not do what will be the word keywords and all, but you can do that. You, and then the entire template you take and you put it there, and then you have to fill in, of course, yourself manually. You have to fill in manually.
Fine, sir. Sir, for example, in Punjab, in Ludhiana, if on the Ludhiana page I am going to edit the name of my college, then can I give the website, my college website reference in Wikipedia?
No. You want to Ludhiana page? What do you want?
Sir, in Ludhiana page, I would like to edit the name of one college.
You want to add?
Yes, sir.
The name
of one college.
So supposing, there must be a heading of education or something.
Yes, education or college or school.
There are schools. There may be, your college is technical college?
Sir, it is a B.Ed. college, G.H.G. Khalsa College of Education.
Okay. So under education, they have schools, agriculture, medical, engineering, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So you can either add one, add one more,
they have given agriculture stream, medical stream, engineering stream, but not education stream. So we can add one more stream.
You can do that. So again, you can add. So for that, you have to edit here, this one. You go to edit here.
Yes.
I'm just showing it to you. Then in order to create one paragraph, what you have to do on both the sides of the heading, you have to write this mark, you know, double equal to this side also and this side also. Just you check. I know I do it like this. So maybe education also you have to do, or you may not do, depends what you want to do. I'm not doing any editing because I have no intention of doing any editing because I'm not confident of that, the content, but you can do yourself. You can do enter here, and the cursor will come here. And then whatever heading you want to give, you can give the heading. Then under the heading, you can give contents. And then yes, giving contents will not be enough. That is something which you have to keep in mind. You supposing, what do you want to add? Let me ask you first. What do you want to write then?
If I would like to add one name of one college. In Ludhiana, there is one college, G.H.G. Khalsa College of Education. For example, one institute name.
So G.H.G. Khalsa College of Education is one of the B.Ed. colleges in Ludhiana.
Ludhiana district, yes.
Supposing you write. Okay. You have written it here.
Yes, sir.
You gave a heading, education.
Yes, then sir.
Given the symbols for a paragraph like this, a heading. And below that, you write that sentence. But with that sentence, you should add one reference. You see, this reference has been added. Check the reference here. It has been added from, it starts from here only. You check from here to here. Now you might ask, where will the reference come from? Yes. Can you tell which the reference, what will be the source of the reference?
Sir, I have suggested one that can it be a website of the college?
No.
Okay.
It is something like, I want to write an article I am the editor. My name is ABC. And I want to write an article on myself in that newspaper.
Okay, fine. It will not be accepted. Then I think they have given one website URL, cityviabestindia.com. I think I have to find the college name.
What is the source? Now, I would like to add a few more things. You should add third party reliable references.
Okay, fine.
Third party,
fine.
You understand, independent source.
Yes, like, sir.
The first party is your college, because that is how you want to write about that. Second party would be some related party about the college or related to the college. Third party is completely unrelated to that. And that can be, if it is in Punjab, if there is an article on your college in the Tribune, that will be a good source. If there is an article in the Hindustan Times, in the Times of India also, that will be, and then you give two sources at least. One may be Times of India, one Tribune. Supposing some activity had taken place, and in that activity, so-and-so college had conducted this activity and this in the, on this date and in which the students had participated on 26 January or what like, whatever. So that established yes, hello.
Hello, sir. Dharunji, can I just add one more point just to simplify the thing?
Yeah. Please.
Dr. Pratap, Paragat ji, the best thing is that the way I do it is if I'm writing an article and I'm looking for information, first I put it on Google. So you can put the college name on Google and check what are the references or what are the websites they're showing. And look for any publications by a news agency, for example, or any third party rather than the their own website.
What is the name of the college?
And sir, then you can put it.
It is GHG.
GHG. G.
Khalsa.
Khalsa.
Sir, it is first one. Khalsa College of Education, Gursar Sudhar. First
this
one, sir.
This one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, on this, mainly you have your own website, No, this you should, Facebook also they don't accept. Social media they don't accept. So you keep on searching on different things. LinkedIn they don't accept. Don't give that blog also, College Dunya, these are not the accepted ones. If University Dunya, no. You get yourself published in some standard thing.
Sir, maybe one can check this on the
Times UGC of site. India.
This
UGC
one.
Website.
This Times of
yes,
India.
Times of India will work.
Times of India you can use. Punjab colleges, no. Please avoid that because then they might delete. So see, this can be a source. This source you can use, Times of India. So I've just shown you one. N number of other places, maybe Tribune it has come to, India Mart, these are no, they don't accept. Twitter and all that, they, social media they don't accept. Just Dial is no, they will not accept. So I have already given you one.
Yes, sir.
So I think you must thank Mr. Datta also for
yes, going. Sir, yes. I'm really thankful to both the source persons for
use this
clarifying source. This. Yes.
Yeah. So this will be a reliable source.
Dr. Arun, may I ask something?
Yeah, please, ma'am.
Yeah, for a beginner, what would you suggest? Like, you had shared your article on Jagjeevan Ram, that institute. Mm-hmm. See, that was placed in Stub class, I guess.
It's an institute. Ma'am, I wanted to know what is your location?
Delhi.
And you have lived in Delhi since your childhood?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Any ancestral place, etc.?
No.
Like
nothing like that.
Your parents migrated from somewhere or something?
Yeah, actually by birth I have been staying in Delhi. So no idea about other places.
So are you interested in certain places which are not well known, where people will not know much about that, but you know more probably?
Yeah, I'll have to think over it. And that's why I'm asking, like for a beginner, how many chances are there to editing?
I will tell
and,
you. Yeah. I will share my own experience. When I started editing, before I started, in fact, I was encouraged by my teacher and others that why don't you write for Wikipedia? Then what I did was, I went to the article on my village because I thought about my village, people will not know, I mean, I will know better than many of the people. Even if my own village people know things, they may not be able to write. So at least I know also, and I would be able to write also. So I added some contents to the article on my village. Then I added some contents. The second place for which I wrote was Rajkot in Gujarat, which is where I had stayed. So I was attached to that. Then I stayed in Bhatinda. I was in Punjab also. Then I added some contents to Bhatinda also. Even now, Bhatinda article requires some improvement. I can show you. You can do some editing of grammar also. I'll just show you.
Exactly. My point was like what all we can edit in these.
Ma'am, you start with minor edits. Start slowly only. Now, let us look at Bhatinda's article. Last time when I had given the demo, I did the correction here. There was a grammatical error. Right. This sentence I have edited because there was a grammar. And if you are correcting a grammatical error, then there is no need to give a source because that is accepted. Because if the verb is missing, for that you don't need a source or citation. So this sentence I had corrected. Now I am just able to see Bhatinda is a home of Central University. I don't know, is something which I don't find as acceptable to me. So I would like to, maybe I may remove it if I, so I can start with something like that. If you start reading articles, you might find a couple of errors, but the topics, if you are familiar with the topic, you might find certain contents which are missing, and you would be angry because, you know, when I started reading the articles on my village and on other places, I was angry. It's not, why is it not there in the digital world? Like Mokamaghat, I created how? Or Patna College, I created how? Because I was upset. Why should there not be an article on my college, which is 150 years old? Then I would do it. And so I created Patna College. But before I created Patna College, before I created Mokamaghat, actually I must have done at least 50 or so or 100 or so smaller edits. Then I created a bigger article. So start with minor edits, ma'am. My suggestion is this.
Okay. And what about today we couldn't discuss about that Wikimedia. Like you said we can post pics also. That institute.
Rajiv Datta has spoken, the entire thing that he spoke was about Wikimedia only. Actually, Wikimedia Foundation is the name of the umbrella under which Wikipedia, Wiktionary and all their projects come. Like here are the projects. The projects are on the main page. Sorry. Anyway, I think Wikimedia is the, you can check here.
No, sir. Actually, my concern is about the pics. Like, let's say the one article you had shared that about Jagjivan Ram Institute, but no pic of that institute is there.
What you have to do is you have to upload a pic on Wikimedia Commons, and that pic you have to share on Wikipedia article. And for that, the best person here is Mr. Datta.
In that case, can I have 5 minutes?
Please carry on.
Though we are over time, if others can stay back, I can also stay back.
Yeah. So I'll stop sharing and I am now winding it up.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for your inputs and all your suggestions. It was again a refreshing for me as well.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sir, one small question.
Yeah, please.
As we have discussed about adding a name of a college in one city, for example, we may not find a digital reference related to that college. But there might be many books written where the reference of that particular college is given. Then we can give the reference of book, any book.
I can give you the answer, Mr. Datta, should I?
Yes, sir, please.
Actually, you are right, Dr. Pargat Singh. Actually, you can give the reference of articles also, newspapers also, news websites also, which are reliable, and books also. And for that, the best source, as Mr. Datta has said, right now digitally, Google is there. You can go to Google Books. You can go to Google Books and you can give the reference from there. And my own experience is that Mokama Ghat, when I was creating, there was no article in the newspaper. So I had to take the help of books. And I gave the reference of books also. You can get the templates of books also. You are right. You can use books.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Mr. Datta.
Yeah, yes, sir. I just like to start how to upload photographs on Wikimedia Commons. That is a very easier way to start joining the umbrella of Wikimedia projects that we have. As Dr. Arunji has said, that micro edits that we often use the word, or small edits, we can start off that all. Again, we started off as, I also started off as editing on Wikipedia before writing the articles. And one more suggestion in regards to Wikipedia is that if you are writing an article, if you want to start an article new, which is not there either in English or in any other languages, and you're thinking to write it in English, for example, just check the forte of the article is about. For example, is it about a place or is it a biography or something? And then I would suggest to check the different articles present on Wikipedia regards to that particular forte. For example, if you're writing a biography, check the different articles of the biography written already, so that you can have an understand what the structure will be about. And from there, you can take and get inspired how to compose your writing. And automatically, people will join one, because it's not possible for a person to finish an article. But there are people, I have done, I think, more than 500 articles I've written on my own from first to last. And then again, people will go on adding as well. So you can just, a start is needed, and then automatically you will go on learning day by day. So I'm just sharing my screen so that we can have a look faster to the Wikimedia Commons. And definitely I will go ahead for any questions if anyone having. Hopefully my screen is visible.
Arunji, can you see me? How many pictures are we allowed to put up in, like, say, suppose, even if it's about our school? Is there a limit or?
No, there's no limit. Unlimited photographs you can upload. No,
but I would like to just interrupt here. Sorry.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Please.
Yeah. What if your school objects?
That is a very valid point. I think Rajiv will tell better.
Yes. That I will explain about the different copyrights issue is there.
Exactly.
Different photographs.
A creative commons is the common term used for open source. So if the media files, photos or videos are can be used by anyone, you can put on creative commons. So Wikimedia Commons is like that only. But while uploading, Rajiv, you can tell how
Yes. You
have to be very, very strictly following the rules of copyrights.
Yes. I'm just going,
even
going
if
to show you.
Taken, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, even please, if taken on your own, so yeah. Even that would include that copyright issue too.
Yes.
You have to write all the details.
Not only that, sir, because suppose I'm taking a photograph of Dr. Arunji. I need a written confirmation if needed before I upload his photograph on the internet. If you're talking about Wikimedia Commons, because anytime. Dr. Arunji can come and says, I didn't give the permission to take a photograph of mine. So even in the conferences that we often attend regards to Wikimedia, there are certain criteria where what the participants tells about themselves, that whether they are allowed to take photographs of themselves or not. So we're given a different a badge that we need to wear just to make sure that the photographers can mark us that we are giving allowing them to take photographs or not.
I think if I recall, Rajiv, not just the permission, but also what is the, which camera you have taken from, what are the specifications of the camera, when did you take the photograph, where did you take the photograph, and also.
Yes, that's true. That has happened with me. I will share a small story if I get a time to. where I got into a bit of trouble while uploading photographs of a place. That I will definitely show. But let me show you the exactly how one can upload photographs. Okay, and a bit of idea about a contest that is going on. So anyone interested here can participate as well. And there are some goodies to one as well. So just log in to this page, commonswikimedia.org. I can share the link on the chat as well for future reference. You can copy it and put it in your This is the link. I'm just taking out the chat. This is the link of the Commons page where anyone can go on and you can log in with your username and password. Now, as you log in, you will see an option called upload file. And now what I do is mostly before I upload a file is that I try to check if I know the photograph that I'm taking. For example, you can see I have put it on the search as of a famous stadium in Kolkata called Eden Gardens. So I'm going to show you how to upload a photograph of that. So I'm just putting Eden Garden on the search option just to check, is there any photograph on Eden Garden already there or not with any other name as well, because we need to have a original title of the photograph as well. So you can see the different Eden Garden name comes up. Eden Garden Stadium at night, 02.jpg. These are different names just to make sure that you can upload it. So if you Eden Garden and then if you click on the search button, automatically it will show you up the different photographs already uploaded about Eden Garden. You can always add as many as photographs of Eden Gardens because it doesn't have any copyright as of now regards to the monuments copyright that we have. Even when I was in Russia has some copyright issues regards to monuments. You can't take all photographs of monuments and upload it on internet. So these are the Eden Gardens will come up, and if we choose, if I choose this one, Eden Garden, Kolkata. The reason I am searching Eden Garden is just to make sure that what are the different things I like to share about. So this is the photograph Eden Garden has taken by someone, not someone. You can see the name. This is the name of the author. I know him. It is Prong$31. He's the username. Description you have to write. So I will show you how to do that. Now we will keep this page open and I will move on to the main page once again and I will show you how to go back to upload file and show you the process one by one. Now anyone can upload it from their mobile phone as well. We have a mobile app as well for Wikimedia Commons. But I do it mostly through laptop when I'm at home. I just take the photographs from my mobile to laptop and because I can get a bigger screen to see what exactly is happening. So select media files is the first option. Now it goes to the directory where you have kept the photographs. I will select one photograph. Now it shows a different name, which we need to change as well. This is the name that I put it when my camera is on. So on the camera features also, you can there's an option where you can put your name as well on the camera. I have a Canon DSLR, so where you can put your name inside the camera in the settings as well. That's important. I will show you how. If I continue this option, they will show you this option, whether this site requires you to provide copyright information for this work. So this file is my own work. So as I have taken the photograph, it's my own work. Now they will tell you to write your name. So this is my username already written here. This is the format that I always used with my username. So you can use this format as well. Or you can simply write your name as well if you want to. Now there are different license to work, but I will always suggest to use this license 4.0, or you can use this as an option to check the different license that we have. Now I will give an example of the why we use this, where if anyone uses this photograph that I'm going to upload, they have to just give us a reference that whose photograph, that the author, that is me, just give a credit, just writing my name on the photograph itself, like with this printing it or selling it or something. So 4.0 is the most common license that we often use for uploading photographs, but you can also change on this. And I will suggest Dr. Arunji, so that we can have a Creative Commons copyright workshop where I can explain each and everything, all the different licenses.
It will be a good idea, yeah, in some other session.
Yes, sir. So for a beginner, you can use this one, 4.0. Then click on next. Now they will ask for the image title. Now the image title, there is no such rule as of, but for a better understanding, because if you want your pictures to be searched well and can be used well by students or by anyone who want to use it. So I think the best description is the name of the place. So I just change it to name of the photograph itself. So it's Eden. Then either you can give a small space, or you can use the underscore, or you can write Eden Garden Stadium, because Eden Garden is also a lot of name of different parks all around the world. So Eden Garden Stadium. Then you write the name of the city. You can also add the state as well, or the country, but I think Kolkata is enough. And then you sometimes add, it's up to you, the actual number of the photograph. Sometimes they have a folder, people keep folder, or use any initials if you feel like. I use a very, you can say it's a good sign of mine. I use the name of my mother, so Ma and Baba that I use. I always write MB in all my photographs, and I did put a number on it. It can be any number. It's a choice of yours. You can do it or not. Then the caption comes, what exactly the picture is. So you can just copy it from here. Paste it here. Again, it's your choice. You can do it just for easier process. Indian Garden Stadium. And you can write a bit of it at Kolkata. Again, thing you're going to have to write on the description. Eden Garden Stadium is a cricket stadium. So you can add as many as thing you can. One thing I also do is that I use Eden Garden Stadium and search on Wikipedia, and I try to write the first sentence of it. So that's also an easier way to give a description if you're thinking what to write exactly. So you can take the help of Wikipedia. Just simply take Eden Garden and search it on Wikipedia articles. And from the first paragraph, you can write one sentence from it, copy it and paste it here. Now, the most important thing is the photograph, because automatically your date will come. Sometimes I've seen that when you're uploading, the date doesn't come automatically. It shows you the date, this 24th November 2019, when I took the photograph in the stadium. These are the timings. If it doesn't come, you can put any date you feel like. Now, the important thing is the category. Category means in which particular segment or group you want to put the Eden Garden. Now, the reason I will tell you why I searched for Eden Garden's pictures on Commons before. Here was the picture that I found out. And I will check what this person has used as category. I will just go down on the page. And this is the categories that he had used. For example, Eden Gardens is itself as a name of a category. So I just copy it from here. And I go back to my upload wizard tab again and put it here. And it will show you up Eden Gardens and the state park. I think it's in the US. This one I will select. Again, I will go back to the old photograph. India-Pakistan cricket match. I think I forgot this. I think it was not India-Pakistan. I forgot the match, actually. So Eden Gardens is enough if you want. You can also check for cricket stadium if there is any category. So you can write that as well. Yes, cricket stadiums. So cricket stadiums in India is not mentioned, so there's no category. So cricket stadiums, and then there's an option called that says publish files. Click on publish. Now this is the new thing that has come up. I think it's 1 year almost. That says add metadata. Now add metadata is a feature by which through artificial intelligence nowadays Wikimedia Commons pictures can be searched through the different items. For example, that means what this picture is showing you up. What exactly you can see on this picture? So you can see a ground, you can see lights, stadiums, people, audience, or so you can write the word stadium and see whether there is any word already saved on Wikidata. This is a feature that is taken from Wikidata and it will show you up stadium is there. So you can click this. Automatically you will see stadium is added to this feature. Now, when you're adding add metadata, this is an option that says skip this step. So you can also skip this step that I'm doing at this moment. And you can just click on this one as well. So, but I always do metadata so that it's easier for Google or anybody to search. So whenever they search anything like stadium, my picture will be on the search list. Now, what do you more see? You can see spectators. Let's see, spectators is coming or not. Show you up. You're searching for any word spectators on Wikidata.
A is extra actually. Okay.
Yes. So there's a lot of option that's saying, but I don't think it's making any sense to me. So remove this. We can also add cricket ground. Don't think it's there as well. You can add more searches. Cricket field, grassy on which the game cricket is played. So you can add this one.
Add cricket matches probably.
Yes, sir, you can add that. Let me see whether we have. So add cricket field, cricket match.
No, it's not there.
Is it still searching? Yes, game in the sport of cricket.
All right.
So these are thing three add address so that if people search for stadium, they will get this photograph or cricket field or cricket match. And now I think it's enough. Publish data for all files. So this is the picture that I have just added. So now you can see, you can just click on this and you will see the picture already uploaded on. So this is the name, Eden Garden Stadium, Kolkata. mb01.jp, that is the name of the photograph. Now that is my name has come up, source own. So these are things that I have added on the process. This is the license. This is the actual description of the license. Anybody can copy it, transmit the work. And we can have a class for that as well. Now it's also the metadata also shows you the camera model. So I have used my mobile phone for this. So this Redmi 5. This metadata will also show you the exact, the different width, height, all the camera features. And these are the different. So if I check the Eden Gardens category, my photograph will be there as well. Now, anytime you can rearrange the category as well, you can add more categories onto your old photograph that is already uploaded, or you can add or even remove from the categories as well. If you feel like, you can change. I will show you how to add category to this photograph. Let me see. So there are so many photographs are there from Eden Gardens.
Sir, so Eden Garden is like free kind of
Yes, Monas, I will tell you about the rule of the monuments in India. Most of them are free, but there are some museums where I've been to. For example, the Salarjung Museum in Hyderabad, where you're not allowed to take photographs. Actually, you can take photographs, but you cannot upload it on any platform. Though there are Facebook doesn't restrict anyone from uploading any photographs, so there you can add it. But as far as the rule says of Salarjung Museum in Hyderabad, you cannot upload the photographs on any online platform. So Macrometa Commons also follow that kind of rule. So if you suppose you by mistake doesn't know the rule, you upload the photographs, administrators or any other officials can see that photograph and they feel they can remove your photograph. They'll simply delete the photograph from your from Wikimedia Commons.
So they won't be penalizing you, simply remove the photograph. That's it.
It depends. Basically, Wikimedia Commons doesn't penalize anyone. But the author or is there any copyright infringement happens, then you can be penalized. So it depends upon the original owner or the particular monument or the house. So for example, if you're taking a picture of any private apartment, for example, the owner have the rights to sue you up as well. So you need a confirmation. Sometimes I will tell you, I've been uploading, I will show you some of the photographs of my list. If you check page.
I think they do penalize them. You may be blocked if you have, violated their rules.
Yes. You can be banned from commons. Yes, you can be banned, but penalized in the sense of imprisonment or fine or money, it doesn't happen in Wikimedia Commons, but you can be blocked for not uploading photographs. So these are some of the categories that I've created. For example, I will show you.
What about if this single pic you have just, like you have uploaded the Eden Gardens pic here. What if you are uploading it on other social media or other sites also? Then is it okay?
I think
I think in Facebook everything is okay.
Should I interrupt, Mr. Datta?
Yes, please, sir.
I think we should now wind up because it's already time for recording. Also, it might take quite a bit of time. Just the last question of.
Okay, sir. Before I end up, sir, I just have one thing to share. I will share this. This is the Wikipedia's 20th birthday is already happening. It happened on 15th January. So we have a competition happening up where I will just share the scope. Where if you are a KD person or you want to do something to celebrate Wikipedia's birthday, please sign up for this. We are asking participants to write a poem or can upload a photograph that you feel. So this is the scope. You can also add audio as well. Maybe sing a song or narrate a short story. You can also add some videos as well. Illustration, you can also draw something, a painting or something, photography. So this is the contest that I'm talking about. You can always come up, you can go to this page and write your name and then you can submit to your
right.
Creative work. I will share, I think Ramesh sir has already shared it on the on our group. I will share it on the WhatsApp group.
Yeah, so
the
party
already
now,
have participated.
You can do now. You can do all that on your group, I think, in the group.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
I will do that. Okay. Thank you for everyone. Thank you for giving me the chance to do some. Please come back to me with any questions you feel like.
I think we have had quite a long session already. So even if there's a question, it should be the last question and quick.
How do you, one quick question, sorry. But how do you go from like, okay, if I've just seen some article on my school, if it's stub class, how do I upgrade it to like a class? Or?
Actually, for that, you should see, basically, Rajiv Datta would be able to help you uploading photos, because photos, videos, and length of the article, then references, interesting stories if they are there. So I think these are certain ways by which you can also you can check the articles of say good articles and how good articles are created and how do they look and compare it with your own. You can then you would be able to learn, I think.
On the main Wikipedia page itself?
On Wikipedia itself, you go to different articles and you check a few good articles, a few featured articles, and then see how they have been rated as featured. You would be able to review and compare. One is this. The other is sometimes it may also happen that your article has been given a C class, but you are confident it should be rated as B or say a good article category. Then you can go for an appeal. You can go write to the editors and you can ask them to review and consider for a higher grade.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So there's so many other things. Actually, you should first of all start doing the editing. And once you start doing, you would be able to know.
I think one of the girls, ladies asked, how many chances are we given to is there any limit on like how many edits we can do? Is there any...